distributed computing is not a new idea. It was already there. Okay. So in Hadoop, what we are doing is very, very simple. Rather than one machine, you take a bunch of machines. Okay. So I will say the bunch is, just for sake of argument, 4. Okay. So I take 4 machines. 1, 2, 3, 4. So I take a bunch of boxes, say 4 boxes, 4 servers, right? And I can download and install this Cloudera or Hortonworks, any of their Hadoop on this. While installing, it will ask me which machine is master, which machine is slave. The idea is one machine has to be master, the rest of them can be slaves. So in this architecture, I come up with an idea, one guy is master and 3 guys are slaves. Fine. So we have not discussed what is the master doing, what is the slave doing, that's later. Okay. But you install Hadoop in a setup that when there is one master and let's say 3 slaves, right? Now the idea here is that if I want to store anything, okay, Hadoop will help me to store among these 3 boxes, right? So I can use the storage space of all 3 boxes. So if each of them are having a 2 terabyte hard disk, I will get a total capacity of 6 terabyte. Yeah, so Hadoop is a framework actually. It is not a software. So one confusion people have is that is Hadoop a software? No, it is a platform. Okay, and I will show you the different components we have in the Hadoop platform. So if you install Hadoop, let's say we don't know anything about Hadoop, but let's say we install it in a 4 system setup. While installing, it will ask you to select one as master, the remaining as slave. So I have one master and 3 slaves, right? And what Hadoop can do, it can take the storage space of all these 3 machines and project it as a single 6 terabyte storage box, right? So the beauty of this architecture is that let's say you start dumping the data and the data gets stored here. And let's say your 6 terabyte is over. I can add machines on the fly. From 3, I can expand to 30,000 without shutting down the cluster. Meaning your storage problem is solved. You don't have to ever worry about storage in a Hadoop cluster. Hadoop allows you resizing without any downtime. So I can add more machines or I can remove machines, up to me to decide, right? But if you're removing, it'll have a problem. For example, if the program is running here, if I remove it, the program might crash because this machine is needed. That is not the idea. If you have one more machine here where nothing is running, I can remove it gracefully. Nothing will happen. So you are getting something called scaling out. This architecture is called scaling out, meaning you keep on adding more machines so that you can get unlimited scalability. Now, I will tell you how storage happens. So far, I did not discuss how storage happens. And if one machine is taking that, it'll have more data, another will have less data. I don't have any way to manage it. Here, that will be handled. I'll show you how that is happening. So this is called a Hadoop cluster. So the technical term for this is a cluster. Cluster is nothing but a group of machines, right? So that is available in a Hadoop cluster. Now, typically, if you go to companies and check with them, like I was with this 24/7, a company called 24/7. They are a call center company. And they run Hadoop clusters for analytics and all. They had a 50 machine cluster, 50 node cluster. Each node has around 256 GB RAM. And 10 terabyte storage. So 50 into 10 is what? Sorry, not 10, what am I saying? 100 terabyte storage. So 50 into 100 is what? 5 petabyte of storage they had. And 256 times 50, that is the RAM capacity of the cluster. That is a very minimal Hadoop cluster, cheap Hadoop cluster. So typically you'll have 500 nodes, 1000 nodes Hadoop clusters. Because the amount of data you're storing is in petabytes. 1,000 terabyte is 1 petabyte, actually. So most of the companies, they will have huge amount of data to dump in this. So the size of the cluster will be in that level, actually. And Hadoop is distributed, meaning if you install it, it is not getting installed in one machine. It is installed in all the machines. And the components will talk. So it runs in a cluster, not in a single machine or 2 machines, actually. Right? So the basic idea in storage is that you can add more machines and get more storage. Right? Now, my point is, if let's say you're buying 500 servers, each server will cost you some money, right? Yeah. So if I say 500 times that money, right? It is really a huge amount of investment for me. That is the reason we call these machines commodity hardware. What do you mean by commodity hardware? Commodity hardware means any machine without any label. You will never buy a Dell server to build a Hadoop cluster. You will build it with cheap throwaway servers. If you look at most of the buses that are here, what is your idea? Citizens need to travel from one point to another point. And the bus should be there. That's all. You are not investing crores in buying Volvo buses everywhere, right? You buy just some bus. Same idea here. In a Hadoop cluster, typical Hadoop cluster, the machines that we use are called commodity hardware. Commodity hardware means assembled servers. So you can get it actually. So you're not actually buying an IBM server, because I was also working as a design architect for one of the Hadoop solution. There we got servers for around 35,000 rupees, 40,000 rupees. 40,000 rupees, you cannot buy a server. If it is an IBM server, you'll pay 2 lakh, 3 lakh. So this was like somebody will assemble and give you. The only thing it will work, it will crash also. It will definitely crash, 100%. So then you will be thinking, if I'm having a 500 node Hadoop cluster, if my slaves are crashing, what is the reliability there? I will answer that question. Just park the question for the time being. Server is what? A server is, so this is your desktop, normal desktop, right? So normally you have something called desktop at home and all. Server is something which can serve multiple clients in one way. It is a bigger box with bigger storage and processing. So if I want to buy a server, I have multiple options. One is that I go and tell IBM or Dell, buy me a server. So they will give me a branded server. So they will charge a lot of money. They will also give me support and all, but I have to pay 2 lakh, 3 lakh for a server. So normally when I say server, this is what people buy. But in a Hadoop cluster, you never do that. You buy cheapest servers possible, because you can afford to have failures in a Hadoop cluster. I'll show you how failures will be handled in Hadoop cluster, but you are not investing a lot of money on the hardware. That is the idea. Because otherwise the solution is not feasible. If I'm buying 500 IBM servers, I can take the same money and give it to Teradata. So as good as same thing, right? So I don't need support or anything. I just need some normal machines. And Hadoop also does not say what kind of a machine you need. You can even build a Hadoop cluster using desktops if you want. Performance will be less, but it'll beautifully work. Or laptops or anything that you want. It doesn't say that. So new businesses might take Hadoop more, because after 5 years, I may not buy Teradata, right? If this is a situation, I might buy a Hadoop solution, probably. Data warehousing is not a new concept. If I go to the market, I can get n number of people who know what is data warehousing, and they can easily install a Teradata for me. I just have to pay money. Building a team of Hadoop expertise is not easy. That is why you're sitting here, right? I go to a company also, if all of them have to understand how Hadoop is working, and Hadoop is not like click, click, install. There are a lot of things you have to configure and tune. So people don't want to spend that much of a risk. So one reason is that the knowledge curve, we call, right, the learning curve is a bit high. You know, you can't learn it in a day and say that, okay, I'll implement Hadoop. It's not possible, right? So most of the companies are stuck in this position.